trail. Just come from Fairlie today. Pretty cool countryside. It's amazing actually. It's pretty awe-inspiring. Here's the dock access thing, so we'll just have a little look at that. So I'm basically just going, I'm just gonna start walking up there and do some binoing, and never know, we might see some tahr on the way up. We'll do a couple hours up there and a couple hours back. It's nice and flat up the creek, so that's quite cool. I could spot something. So that's looking up Bush Stream. So I just came a little way up this afternoon because I just didn't have enough time. I had a couple hours. But I'm going to head right up the back tomorrow. Well, I'm just heading up Bush Stream again this morning. I'm going to head up this little area here. I was looking on the map last night. It's called the Sawtooth. I went up there, I sort of headed up that ridge way up there last night as far as I could with the time I had left, and had a bit of a look around up there. Got a really nice face and gully and bluffs here that I can check out, and if there is something around, this looks like there's some good ways to approach up the side of that face. It's pretty awesome. It's the first time I've been in country like this, to be honest. I love it. We'd have to be back again. Anyway, let's see what the time is and have some lunch. Just check the time, and it's only actually bloody 10:30. I thought it was near midday, so looks like a bit more time. I might even do a little sortie around the corner there. I've got some main lunch, Subway. Got a foot long. I'm stoked. Anyway, got the whole camera set up, and I'll get the old man. Got a bit of sport for this trip. The old man loaned me his old Swarovskis, 10x42 SOCs. These are mean. They're perfect for up here. I've just got up, climbing right up near those bluffs. Looking down the valley. The car is way down by the river there, so it's a fair hike. A few hours, a few k's. But anyway, these are those bluffs. So, I know there's tahr in there because I saw one earlier on moving around. Well, what was one to stand here now turned out to be three, and moving up the hill. Quite a mature one, that top one, by the looks of things, I'm guessing. Get up to that point over there. Yeah, it's certainly not the lack of animals. It's the terrain. Just capture someone. He's on the 550. Got a little bit of a problem. It's 3:30 already, and I actually have to think about moving on. Typical, like, get amongst all the animals and. It doesn't matter, it's all good. It's good to actually see a big chunk like that. Man, I wish I had one more night in the last fly camping. wake up and you'd be amongst them. Just spotted a bull. He's off to the right from sort of the main mob. I've been sitting here for about half an hour now, and what started off as two ended up to being about 13 or 14. And then this guy, I'll just zoom in on him. This guy turned up, and while he's not huge, something quite nice to take home. But the problem is I'm really running out of time. Good just to see him come down a bit further, or if I could maybe leave the pack here, it's not hard to find. Get it around those rocks to the right to take the knife. See if we could get up to that point up there. Could probably get him within a shooting range. But they'd only be probably about 250. That's quite doable. Now where is he? Yeah, you know, he's alright, eh? I mean, it's really easy getting down to the river, so even if I did get back at dark, got a good headlamp. But there's not much point thinking about it. Let's see if I can go and get this guy. Right, it's supposed to move.
Well, after a big day, I finally managed to pick up a bull, and I'm really stoked because I was about half past three, and I was thinking about going home and heading back to the car, and then I just picked out this guy. There were heaps of nannies and young ones around, and I was filming them for a few hours, and then I finally spotted this guy off to the right, and. He's not a monster, but he's still pretty awesome. I'm really stoked, eh? Got a pretty cool big mane and stuff. So it's actually the first time I've been up close to a tahr, and it happens to be a bull. So I'm stoked, eh? But I've actually got to think about heading home soon because I'm already going to be getting home well into dark, and I've still got quite a way to go. So I'm pretty much up the top of that hill that I thought I would not be going up. But I guess I've sort of learnt that that's what it's all about, eh? Tahr hunting. A newfound respect for these animals, that's for sure. They're not just a big woolly goat, they're pretty amazing. It's been really good watching them all day today and just seeing how they get around and stuff. So, anyway, I've got to get going because the sun's about half an hour from going behind the hill.